Afternoon all. Just having another look at the list array and just got round to gapping the piston rings, or checking the gap rather. Please excuse all the mess in the background, just got to do it on something soft so I don't damage the paint. This mat happened to be here. Anyway, what I do to check this, put a piston ring in the top of the bore, or the bottom as it may be, and then use the piston just to push it down a bit further, as near as possible to where it's going to be working. Now, I should explain, on the list array there's a sort of groove down the bottom of the cylinder there in the combustion chamber, so whatever you do, don't let the rings go too low or you'll never get them back out again. Anyway, that one looks quite good, so I'll go and get my feeler gauges and see what the gap is. Okay, well, I've checked all the rings in the bore now. The compression rings sit at about 11 thou and the oil scrape is 13 thou gap, so that's pretty good. You want somewhere between 10 and 12 ideally, so we're pretty much there. So yeah, I'm going to clean up the piston a bit, get the rings on that and in the bore. Before I do, I should add, I'm going to just take the sharp edges off the rings. Shouldn't cause any damage, but sometimes it's just worth doing to avoid damaging the bore, you know, while it's running in. Well, I've put all the piston rings on. That was really easy, just did that by hand. Always makes me a little nervous. There's 50 quid's worth of rings there, so I didn't want to break any. But no, they went on a treat, so it was fine. I've just shimmed up the big end, checked that on the crank, and I've put the gudgeon pin in, little circlips in there as well. That's a really snug fit, so that's nice. What I'm going to try and do now, take the big end cap and shells out, put the piston in the bore, fairly high up the bore, and then try and drop the cylinder on onto these studs here. Now hopefully I can then, if I put the crankshaft at bottom dead centre, I should be able to land the big end shell straight on the top, and then put the cap back on, we'll be ready to go. I'm going to stop work there for tonight. The engine's coming along quite well, and I don't really want to do too much more to it now. I don't want to rush. The crank's in, big end's all shimmed up, tightened up. I've just put the crankcase door on to keep dirt from getting in there for now. Tighten down the mounting bolts for the hopper and cylinder casting. Fitted the governor side bearing housing. It's had four coats of paint now. Just picked out the oiling hole in silver. Little bit of end float, but it's less than it was. I've reduced it with thinner gaskets. Very little lift in that, if any actually. This one's got a little tiny bit, but barely detectable. Now it's all got oil around it. Particularly pleased with the exhaust. The can itself's had two coats of paint, and the pipeworks had three, made a gasket for it. So I've just got one more coat of paint to put on the silencer can, and then just by hand I'll finish that off once it's tightened up. Little fuel pump. All in all, quite pleased with it so far. I was a bit worried that it might be really tight, but even with the new piston rings, it's good. Once it's got a flywheel on, it'd be really easy to turn, so I don't think anything will get hot. Yep, so there you go. Hopefully, it won't be long till it's running now.